thinking is, I'm an Episcopal. I'm an Episcopal church here. We don't talk about Satan here in the Episcopal church, right? But every once in a while we can. We're going to do that today. Because in this story we have today for the scripture, it's kind of an interesting thing here. We have Peter running up to Jesus and trying to protect him, and Jesus pushes him back and says, "Get behind me, Satan." Kind of a weird thing for him to say to his disciples. And here we are in the season of Lent. And part of what I want to share with you all is how this season of Lent is very important to us as Christians, because it is actually a protection, a secret tool, maybe a special power we get as Christians against Satan in our lives. Lent is. In this 40 days that we gather together for Lent, and we adopt different spiritual disciplines, or we give up things for Lent, and the purpose behind all of that is to try to grow closer to God. That there's distance between us and God in our lives, and we want to make amends for that. We want to grow closer again. And part of how we do that is we give up the things in Lent that are getting in the way. When we take on new disciplines during Lent that help bring us closer again. And I want to share with you all that in the midst of that distance is where we can find Satan in our lives. And we run the risk sometimes of anthropomorphizing Satan too much. Thinking of him as the red devil with the horns and the pitchfork and the pointy tail, and he's kind of like the boogeyman, really. You know, hiding under our beds or in a closet. And the danger in that is what happens is we all grow up, and we go off to college, we get jobs, we get married and have kids, and we retire and all these things, and we come to see over time that there isn't anything under that. There isn't any boogeyman hiding in the closet, and we could make the mistake of thinking that's what we've turned Satan into in our minds, that he's not real. But I assure you, Satan is a very real thing in our lives. It's a very real danger to our relationship with God. We may also make the mistake sometimes when we read the gospel, especially in the Gospel of Mark, where we read about Jesus Christ is very much like our superhero who's come to save the day. We may make the mistake of looking at Satan and seeing him as sort of an evil villain in the story, the super villain that Jesus is battling. And the danger in that is that it puts Satan outside of us as some bad actor on the outside. And it kind of alleviates us, absolves us of some responsibility that we bear. It's just, well, that's not my fault. That's Satan working on me. That's Satan tempting me in my life. That's not my fault. I actually had a student in All Saints just the other day. He didn't turn in one of his assignments, and he shared with me he tried to, but Satan got in the way. I told him, I know we're a Christian school here, but even that doesn't apply here. But there's this very real danger to think of it as something on the outside, and not as something Satan is working, struggling with on the inside. When we gather together for this season of Lent, look at some things that teach us about Satan. One of the stories, anybody heard this story running about where Satan supposedly comes from? That he was one of God's angels, but he decided, I see some nods already, he was one of the angels, and he decided that he didn't want God to be in charge, he wanted to be the one in charge. He didn't want to have to rely on God, he wanted to be able to trust in himself, be the one calling the shots. And so he was cast down for that. I see a bunch of times you've heard this story. And it makes me wonder, in this season of Lent, as we are examining the things that are driving a wedge between us and God, I wonder how much of that, for how many of us, that's the desire to be in control. That's the desire not to want to have to rely on God. To maybe even resent the fact that God's the one calling the shots, because we want to be the ones calling the shots. And actually, that is Satan driving a wedge in that relationship between you and God. I like to be in control. I get that. I don't want to have to trust on somebody else, to rely on somebody else to keep their word. It's a hard thing to do. It's a vulnerable thing to do. And so this season of Lent, maybe that's the discipline you've taken on, is for 40 days letting go of having to be the one in charge. But mimics the 40 days Jesus walked out in the wilderness, right? And at the end of those 40 days in the wilderness, who does he run into? Runs into Satan, right? He tempts him. He says, believe in me, worship me instead of God, and I'll give you everything you could ever want. Trust in me, and I will make you happy. I will give you what you're looking for. Tempts him. And it makes me wonder, in this 40 days of Lent, how often is that the thing that's driving the wedge between us and God? Something else in your life that's tempting you away. Maybe it's power, maybe it's money, sense of security. For a lot of people in our society today, I know it's money. The Lord is saying, worship me, and I can make you happy. Worship me, and I will give you what you want. How much of us for this season of Lent, we could be adopting a discipline where we let go of that, and we say, we're putting our trust in God. And then this very story here in the gospel today, when Peter comes up to Jesus, because Jesus is sharing God's plan, and it sounds dangerous to Peter, and he doesn't like it, and he's afraid. And so out of his fear, he runs and tries to stop Jesus. And Jesus says, get behind me, Satan. And it makes me wonder, in this season of Lent, how often is the thing that's driving the wedge between us and God, how often is it our fear? Our fear that we know what is right, we know what God wants us to do, but we've been there. Times when I've struggled with being afraid to do what I know is right, and it drives a wedge between me and God, that's Satan at work there. Now, fortunately for us, we gather together as friends in the season of Lent. We've got the season of Lent on our side as our secret weapon against Satan. And we can do exactly what Jesus said in this story. To look at Satan in the eye, to look at that thing that's driving a wedge between us and God and say, get behind me. For this 40 days, get behind me, Satan. So what is it in your life that's holding you back? Is it the need to be in control? And for 40 days, you just say, get behind me. I'm setting my mind on godly things, not worldly things. Is it trusting in something else that's got a grip on you? Is it alcohol, or is it money, or is it gambling, or something else that you're seeking comfort from instead of God because it's assured you that it's what you want? You can say, for 40 days, get behind me, Satan. And maybe it's you. Maybe it's the fear that's got a grip on you, driving the wedge between you and God. And just for these 40 days, not forever, but just for these 40 days, to say, get behind me, Satan. That's something that we can adopt as a discipline with each other this season of Lent. So if we, as a group, walk away from this story with nothing else, I want us to walk away with A, Satan is a very real thing in our lives, and it's got a grip on us. It's very real, we should acknowledge that. Driving a wedge between us and God. But B, there's something we can do about that. Because in this season of Lent, we can hold each other together and look Satan in the eye and say, get behind me, because I am setting my mind on godly things, not on worldly things.